The only reason I was glad for the pandemic in regards to Tiffany is that I was like, finally, she's going to get some sleep.
And I didn't.
This is What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix is a Joke Radio.
They Ready is so successful because Netflix listened to me. I think that's Gossip, Dean Edwards, Aaron Jackson, Kimberly Clark, Barbara Carlisle, and Tony Woods. These are my friends. These are comics that have inspired me, that always make me laugh. And I believe in my heart and soul, they are superstars. They've been superstars in my life for many years, and I feel like I need to share that with the world.
We've interviewed everybody from this season of They Ready, and this is the cherry on top.
Wow, wow, and to think I lost my cherry and y'all found it. Okay.
That's what I'm known for.
Oh, okay. You're a cherry founder. Okay. Okay, good. Okay.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you. I am on cloud 9. I'm up in the Apple cloud.
Yeah.
And I'm seeing everybody pictures and hidden stuff, you know. Tiffany, man. Unicorn. I never thought I'd be saved by a unicorn. I always thought I was going to find my Prince Charming, but I found a black unicorn.
That's right.
Tiffany.
You know, I just want the best for you.
Tiffany, this was, I think, one of the only specials filmed during the pandemic. That you were able to pull that off was crazy.
Yeah, we did it outside the Long Beach Theater. The thing that I loved the most about it, people were coming out of their apartments, sitting on their patios, watching the show.
Yeah,
and
that's cool.
And that's wow. So great because they got a free show. So It added to the ambiance, you know? It was so funny because I know Godfrey's like, man, it was a helicopter and it was a siren went by and my special going to be messed up. I was like, no, don't worry. We got every table mic'd. Everybody's mic'd.
And then I had a helicopter call.
Was right. Helicopter
he said, yeah, the helicopter.
I did my joke over again. It was like this.
I can hear it in the mic.
Okay, I was like this.
You were up for the fucking helicopter.
Just as you were talking about.
Right. You manifested that shit.
Right, look at you.
How are you guys doing? Good? It's not a lie. Fuck no. You have a mask over your mouth. You're not doing good. You must be hot as shit. Look at you guys. I know you're laughing, but it's weird. Fuck. I feel like you're being kidnapped, like 24 hours, right? You know what's so funny? Is every girl is fine as hell in a mask. Oh, see, that's what's fucked up. Everybody's a supermodel from here up. God damn. What's up with you? God damn. Keep that mask on. Is that that 9-5?
You don't, in your mind, think, oh, now I'm going to just pop on Netflix this year during a pandemic.
No.
But that's... But because you kept at your craft the whole time, when they come to you,
mm-hmm.
It's...
You are indeed ready.
They're ready. Yeah. Are you getting any complaints that there's too many white people on it?
Or like, Tiffany, why didn't you put anybody white on this time? And I was like, because it's black people time right now. On season 4, maybe 5, I'll do some white.
That part of the trailer is so perfect. You're like, and everybody's black because I'm black. Is that too much?
Yeah, that was great. That ensemble that you put together, you know, everybody brought a different piece to the comedy game.
Godfrey, Tony Woods, Aaron Jackson, Barbara Carlisle, who's, I didn't realize that she, when she said she'd been doing it for 44 years, I was like, geez, yeah. Star Wars had just come out, you know?
Yeah.
I was thinking about lightsabers, you know, and she was already doing this, you know? And then and Kim Clark, it was just, I that made it even more special because I knew that Tiffany, Paige and Wanda had really chosen people that were deserving of an opportunity and deserving of specials. And also knowing that each of them would, including myself, each of us would bring a different perspective and you wouldn't get a repetition of material and no one was going to say, well, are you doing those jokes? Because I want to do those jokes. Like we all had such varied approaches.
Yeah, I'm just in awe of everybody that's on the lineup. Like I wrote everybody like a thank you note at the end. I'm such a dork.
Oh, that's great. I love that.
I'm a dork.
All right.
ran into somebody I hadn't seen in 2 years, and she looked at me and she was like, "Oh my God, Kim, you look the same. You haven't changed at all." I was like, "It's only been 2 years." Exactly how much wear and tear did you think I was gonna go through in a 2 year period? You know, when I saw this girl at a party 2 years ago, and when I turned and walked away, I wondered, did she turn to her friends and say, "You know what, in 2 years, that bitch is gonna look like Yoda. In 2 years, she's gonna look like a Forever 21 dress after the first washing. Nothing but threads and rags. Just a heap of rayon on the floor. That's all she's gonna be."
How were you able to prep for it? Like, were you able to do any other shows leading up to it?
When I got the call from Tiffany, I had done an outdoor show at UCLA. So that was like the first time I did stand up in like months.
And as you know, when you're gonna do something big on a Friday, you hit stages mm-hmm. every night, and it was, yeah, nothing. You know, like I know a lot of comedians, they prepare. They do stuff like called writing jokes and being ready. And I don't, that's crazy, isn't it? Yeah.
They call it, they ready.
I was a mess, so.
What do you mean?
I was a mess. I am such a, like a nitpicker. And it was one of those things where it's like, oh my goodness, you get this opportunity that's such a big opportunity in your career.
Yeah.
And you have no stage time to prepare. Yeah. The new jokes you're writing, you're like, I don't know if people are going to laugh these. I haven't said them to anybody, you know?
Wow.
And
yeah.
So it's very much a, like, you had a handful of shows on a rooftop or in a park, yeah, and that was it.
We had Godfrey on yesterday, and he was just in Florida doing five shows.
Oh, wow.
Max capacity, no masks, people just living a whole
Florida.
Different life down there. Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't give a fuck.
Oh my God.
I went to a club. Listen, they're partying like they found the cure.
Oh no.
Holy shit.
We went to a club, a cigar bar, right?
Yeah.
And we had our mask, and everyone's looking at us like, what the hell with them? They're dancing and hugging.
Oh my God.
It was Caligula, man.
No, thank you, Florida. This happened the other day. I was walking into the hotel and a woman got in my revolving door section with me on purpose. Like, she squeezed in there like she was about to miss the train. I was like, really, bitch, you couldn't wait for the next triangle? You had to be in my triangle. Why are you in here? You're supposed to be social distancing. I'm damn near giving you a piggyback right now. I hate everybody. Like, that wasn't even okay in the before times. I don't know if that's ever happened to any of you guys. Infuriating, right? Right? Because, like, you're in there with this person that you hate, but now in order to get inside the building, you gotta be teammates with this person, right? You gotta work together and take the little tiny steps so don't nobody fall. Oh my, I never wanted to fight a stranger so bad in my life. It's so funny. The things that we are doing now would be like things we never, like, is it outside is a thing that would turn me off from a show for the first 99% of my career.
It's
like,
really true.
Like, is it outside? No, definitely not.
What was the setup? What did that picture look like?
It was at the, how do you call it? The Long Beach Convention Center. I think that's right. And we were just like outside on the plaza, but it was literally just regular round tables with chairs and tablecloths. And it just looked amazing.
Thank God. It was really foggy and overcast. Mm-hmm. So it gave you the feel of being in a nightclub. Because I don't really like the outdoor thing. But the fog was hanging so low, it was like, bang, okay, this is where I am. I'm like, I'm back home now.
Yeah.
We actually filmed where Richard Pryor did one of his specials. I don't know if you guys were aware of that.
Oh, no, I didn't know that.
I wasn't aware of that.
You know, Richard Pryor shot his special back in 1979. And that's the place I always wanted to, like, shoot my own special. But couldn't go inside, so we did it outside.
And this is where Richard Pryor, live in concert, 1979, shot in Long Beach. Yo, this is amazing. This, now that I know that, it's going down. We hitting them in the head like Tyson.
I didn't go see Black Panther initially when it first came out, y'all. I didn't. That, now you heard that, right? Right? You know Black Woman Sears when you hear that, you know? Now, I take it you went to see it immediately, huh? You went and saw it the first, you probably bought a dashiki in the whole nine, huh? the thing, you know, because the title of the movie is Black Panther, and for those that might not realize, I am black, right? But I waited, and here's the thing. If something black comes out and you don't support it, you gotta keep that on the low. Otherwise, black people look at you like you sold out. At least that's what they said at the meetings, right? And so I waited, but I didn't tell people that I waited. I lied, I played along. Anytime I'm out in public, my friends talking about Black Panther, I wrote, like, I'm in the barbershop, and my friend's like, yo, son, yo, man, yo, did you see Black Panther? I was like, did I see Black Panther? What? Why? I turned into DMX. What? Of course I saw that movie. What?
How great is Tony Woods? People don't understand what the impact that he's kind of had on the whole, like, multiple generations now of comedy. Yeah. And he's not even that old. It's not like he's an old guy.
Right.
But he, but even for Chappelle during the Mark Twain Award,
that was
call out and talk about what an amazing comedian and influence Tony Woods is.
Of everyone that I found out I was taping with, when I heard Tony, I was like, yes.
Yeah, it's so
like,
good.
Tony's someone I think we've all wanted to see the world recognize how amazingly great and brilliant he is for years, if not decades.
Tony and I are like oil and vinegar.
Oh, really?
Oh, no.
No, not really. I love Tony.
I can see that.
He is a genius. I mean,
I
love everybody that was on there, but Tony Woods, man, he is phenomenal.
Tell Tony I said, what's up? I love him. He's a whole vibe, man.
Yeah.
Amazing. Legend.
Everyone's so excited to be on the show with you.
Get out. Why is that?
Yeah.
I don't know why. That's what I keep asking everybody.
Why?
I want to give a special shout out to my OG, Tony Woods. Miles Davis has a quote. It's one of my favorite. Miles Davis said so much cool shit, but one of the things he said I always loved, he said, it took me years to learn how to play like myself. You know, he would watch other musicians and he would try to play like Dizzy or Bird or all the guys who were great. Tony Woods was my Dizzy and Bird if I was a Miles. I was trying to play like you. You were the first person I ever saw do it absolutely right. You were fearless and you told the truth.
What was it like to have your buddy Chappelle tell the whole planet you were his inspiration?
You ever been in an airport and you get to the airport and your flight's supposed to leave at 12:30? Mm-hmm. And you go to the gate and they go, ah, it's been pushed back. It's going to leave like 1 o'clock now. So walk around, go to read some books in the bookstore, you know, just do whatever. And you're in the bookstore, you're standing next to somebody you don't know. And they go, Tom Papa, report to gate 12. And you look over and you go, did they just say my name?
That's funny.
That's how it
We stand around, right? And you see this little bird coming to you. Right, it's like, oh, look at that little bird. And then they get close, like, oh shit, that's mosquito. Motherfucker. Right, this mosquito's big as shit. You can see his face. Yeah, you know how bugs go, nah, nah. I can see him doing that going, nah, nah, nah. And I'm there and I'm with this woman, right? We kinda on vacation. Yeah. Yeah, anyway, but you know, she complained about something. And then he said, and while she telling me I ain't shit, he landed like right on the neck. And he looked at me and said, and then I always thought the mosquito little needle was on his head, like, and suck your blood. No, it's right here in the middle. Yeah, like a dick. Cause he leaned back, right? And I was thinking I should say something. But I didn't. And then he just went, and I was like, that's fucked up, and I'm watching this, right? But then karma kicked in, cause he looked at me and said, you next, shorty. I'm like, ooh! Felt like prison again.
I want to thank Tiffany for taking a chance on me, cause she knows a lot of people, and they're, you know, there's people that go way, way back with her. And so for her to even consider me for this, it's like, I'm just deeply humbled by the whole thing.
And Tiffany, I'm going to tell you something, man. When I hosted the live show, it was in November. She pulls me into her green room and says, I need you to do the second season of the Netflix thing. I need you to do it. Right. She goes, listen, Godfrey, I know you should have already had an hour special, but sometimes, mm-hmm. you know, things have to happen a different way. She goes, just do it. I said,
yeah,
I will. And for her to have the wherewithal, she just became famous. And she's already helped 12 comedians in 2 years.
Tiffany, no joke. Everybody that has been on over the last week was so grateful. I mean, truly, truly grateful, because these are a lot of veterans who people really didn't give a platform, who have been killing it for years all around the country.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm so grateful to all of them. I mean, every single one of them has touched my life in some way, helped me grow. I mean, Barbara taught me about makeup. Look, I'm wearing eyelashes.
That's right.
She was already wearing makeup by the time stage time was over. She had danced it off. So she didn't have to do it. And that's that's the great thing about it, because, you know, on this comedy course, through all the sexism and all the other kind of things that are going on as a female comic, for a black unicorn to just show up and come and give me a ride, that was like, you know, God, Tiffany, you know, if you ever quit comedy, I mean, I don't like women, but I'll start.
And how many men out here claim they know when a woman faking an orgasm? No, you don't. You don't know, because she don't even know no more. I had my husband ask me, why come you don't tell me when you have an orgasm? I said, hell, you ain't never around. What I'm supposed to do, get up and call your ass?
Barbara Carlisle, Tiffany Haddish, They Ready, Season 2. You guys are the
season
best.
Season 2.
Barbara, thank nice you. To meet you.
Nice meeting you too, Shirley Temple.